Welcome back to Logitech. Recently, I curious about comparing the high conductive thermal pad with thermal paste. Well, I will use this Zizio thermal pad. This one have 12.8 watt per meter Kelvin. It's really high conductive thermal pad. This one usually used for VRAM, or maybe you can use it also for the NVMe with the heatsink. I comparing with the quite cheap but high conductive thermal pad, the ZF12. This one have 12 watt per meter Kelvin, so it's actually pretty same with the thermal pad. I'm going to test with Core i5-11400F. So let's get to the testing now. I'm using my Jonesbo CR1000 CPU cooler to test. Room ambient is about 28 degrees Celsius. This is the result when using thermal pad ZF12. When running Cinebench R23, the CPU temperature only 63 degrees Celsius at max. Really nice job. Now let's change to thermal pad. I already cut it to match the CPU EHS size. This thermal pad quite hard, so you should not worry to give more pressure on it. Well, the result is not what I expected. When using the thermal pad, the CPU reached 95 degrees at max. It's not throttling, but the difference is significant. From the test just now, we can see that this thermal pad actually not good for the CPU. It's more than 30 degree different with using thermal paste. Well, this one can only use for either IC like VRAM or maybe like the IC of NVMe. For CPU or maybe the GPU chip, you really need thermal paste to cool down it. The 30 degree difference is really huge. It's not just a little. It's not throttling because I use the good GPU cooler. But it's not recommended to use thermal paste as the CPU cooler. It's really hot. It's much different than the thermal paste, even though it have more watt per meter Kelvin from the spec. Well, that's the test from me. If you like this video, please press like and subscribe. And thanks for watching.